Till now, I have explained in detail what all comes under definition of sexual harassment, who is an aggrieved woman, who is a respondent, who is an employee, and who is an employer. Now, coming to when and how the aggrieved woman can approach the ICC. Now, what is ICC? Who all does come under ICC? Or what constitutes ICC? Who has to constitute the ICC? Let me explain in detail about these concepts now. Coming to ICC, ICC stands for Internal Complaints Committee, which every employer at his organization has to constitute mandatorily. This is a statutory compliance and non-negotiable. As I said previously, any organization having minimum 10 people, irrespective of the genders, the employer has to constitute the ICC, that is Internal Complaints Committee. Now, who can be a member of this ICC? The ICC has to have minimum quorum of 4 people, constituting of one chairperson, who is always a senior women employee at the workplace. Senior women employee means a person who has got that expertise, experience, subject knowledge. More than anything else, it is the empathy the woman can show to an aggrieved woman. That kind of experience and expertise should have to a person who occupies the position or the chair of the chairperson. And mind you, chairperson should always be a senior women employee. In case if there is no senior women employee available at a particular unit or department or at one particular company, then from the sister concerns or from the group companies or from subsidiary companies, they can nominate as a chairperson. Coming to other members, at least two members should be from the organization itself. Again, the qualification for these two people all again should be these two persons should be of having legal knowledge or adequate knowledge on women related issues, and one external member should be there. Again, the person should be either from NGO or a person with legal knowledge, and the qualification is that the person should be having adequate knowledge on women related issues. Now, let me explain, when once the act of sexual harassment was committed, when and how and within what time the aggrieved woman has to approach the ICC. The aggrieved woman, when once she feels aggrieved by such kind of sexual harassment or the act of sexual harassment, she has to make a complaint in writing within 90 days from the date of happening of the event. For example, if the event has happened on 1st of May, then from that day, within 90 days, the aggrieved woman or the woman who feels aggrieved about it has to approach within 90 days from that date. If in case there are series of events happening or happened, then from the date of happening of each such individual event, she has to approach the ICC with a complaint in writing within 90 days. And from the date of receipt of the complaint, the ICC has got time of 90 days to complete the inquiry and to give the report followed by the recommendation to the employer. Mind you, when once the ICC completes its inquiry and gives the report and recommendation, it is final and binding on the employer. And the Act has no appeal provision given for the report, against the report or the recommendation of the ICC. So whatever the ICC gives the report and gives a recommendation to the employer, it is final and binding. In case if the parties are not happy about the report or the recommendation of the ICC, then they can only approach an appropriate court of law against such report. Within the organization, there is no appeal provision. Let me clarify. Till now, I am explaining in detail and seriously about what all constitute of sexual harassment, the scope and how to redress in case any complaint of sexual harassment received by the ICC. At this juncture, I just want to explain one more aspect or one more angle of this complaint of sexual harassment. In my experience as an external member as well as chairperson on few companies, it has come to my, it has come to me or to the ICC where there are few false complaints, fraudulent complaints and malicious complaints also. So let us look into what exactly constitute a false complaint or a malicious complaint and how in those cases the ICC has to handle the complaints. So in case of a false complaint where the complainant also knows that to her knowledge also it is a false complaint, and when the ICC comes to a conclusion that this is a false complaint and the complainant has made for no good reason, just for a selfish motives and all, the ICC will not take any adverse action or it will not recommend the employer to take any kind of action or any sort of action on the respondent. Even in those cases where the complainant comes with a false evidence, in those cases also ICC does not recommend the employer to take any action against the respondent. Coming to the aspect of malicious complaint with a fraudulent intent, but that means the aggrieved woman, that is the woman comes to the ICC with a malice, with a hatred, with a hidden agenda against the respondent. In those cases, how should the ICC respond or react or look into the case? So as I said, in case of malicious complaints where there is a fraudulent intent, and if the ICC comes to a conclusion this is not a good case or this is a case of malicious complaint with a fraudulent intent, then such conduct of the woman who comes to the ICC, that is a complainant, the ICC can recommend to the employer to take appropriate action construing that particular act of filing a fraudulent complaint under grave misconduct and taking and recommending the employer to take appropriate action for such kind of fraudulent complaint with malicious intent or malicious complaint with fraudulent intent, vice versa.